فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ فَقَدِ اهْتَدَوْا وَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَإِنَّمَا هُمْ فِي شِقَاقٍ.
لا فلا مضل له ولا ضل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، نتكلم بإذن الله تعالى عن ما بقي معنا من المسح على العمامة وعلى الخمار الذي يكون للنساء.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. وبعد، we're going to carry on discussing that which remains with us from the previous lesson regarding wiping over the turban and wiping over the headscarf or the khimar or the hijab of a woman.
نعم يصح أن يمسح على العمامة التي يصعب نزعها وهي التي كانت تلبس زمن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، هذا على ما يذكر الشيخ بن عثيمين رحمه الله تعالى.
شيخ
أما بن هذه ليست بعمامة. نعم.
شيخ بن عثيمين رحمه الله he mentions that it is permitted for a person to wipe over the imama, to wipe over the turban, if it is difficult for a person to remove it. And it has to be the turban which was worn at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So what the Shaykh is wearing, the scarf, this isn't considered as a turban.
نعم والمرأة تمسح على خمارها.
And as for the woman, then she also wipes over her headscarf.
تمسح على الغالب.
And she wipes over the majority of it.
أما إذا كان على أحد أعضاء الوضوء جبيرة يعني مثل الجبس ماذا يصنع؟ نعم.
And if a person is wearing a bandage or a covering over one of the body limbs of wudu.
نعم. نقول الواجب عليك أن تغسل ولا بد.
We say that the obligation upon this person is that he has to wash. This is the obligation.
فإن استطاع أن يغسل لا بد أن يغسل العضو.
So if he is able to wash his that limb, then he must wash it.
ما استطاع نقول امسح.
If he isn't able to wash that limb or that body part, then we say wipe over it.
نعم يعني مثلا هنا على يديه مثلا هنا جرح.
So for example, we have a person and on his left arm is a cut.
نعم نقول لابد أن تغسل.
We say that you have to wash.
قال لا استطيع.
He says I'm not able to.
لأنه لو جاء شيء من الماء على هذا الجرح يضر بي.
Because if any water touches the cut, then perhaps it's going to harm him.
نقول توضأ وعندما تأتي لهذا العضو امسح على الجرح.
So we say to him that wash the rest of your body parts and when it comes to this body part where the cut is, then wipe over it.
قال لا استطيع.
He says I'm not able to do so. I'm not able to wipe over it.
لا نغسل ولا نمسح.
Neither am I able to wash nor wipe over it.
نقول توضأ وضوء كامل دون هذا العضو.
Then we say to
دون هذا الموضع.
Okay, perform wudu completely. Washing all of the body parts apart from this section.
وبعد أن انتهى من الوضوء يتيمم.
And after you have finished from performing wudu, then make tayammum.
التيمم كما تقدم ينوي بقلبه يسمي.
And tayammum, as we mentioned previously, is a person has the intention in the heart. He mentions the name of Allah.
ثم يضرب ضربة واحدة على الأرض ثم يمسح الوجه ظاهر اليمنى وظاهر اليسرى.
And then he places his hands once upon the earth, or hits the earth once with his hands, and then he wipes over his face and he wipes over the outer part of his hands.
نعم، فهذا التيمم يقوم مقام غسل ترك غسل هذا الموضع.
So this tayammum is done in order to take the place of that body part which he didn't wash.
ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى ما يتعلق بتغسيل الميت وتكفينه والصلاة عليه.
The author in the book which we are studying, Durus al-Muhimma, he also spoke about the preparation for the funeral prayer and that which relates to the funeral burial and procession.
نعم. يقدم الميت أمام الإمام.
So the deceased person, the body of the deceased person is brought in front of the Imam.
ويقف الإمام عند رأس هذا الميت.
And the Imam, he stands level to the head of the deceased person.
وفي وسط المرأة.
And if it's a woman, then the middle of the woman.
يكبر تكبيرة هي تكبيرة الإحرام.
And the imam, he makes the first takbira, the takbira to ihram, the takbira to initiate the prayer.
ثم يستعيد ويسمن ويقرأ الفاتحة كاملة.
And then after this, he seeks refuge in Allah by saying أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. He mentions the name of Allah by saying بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, and he recites Surah Al-Fatiha, all of it.
ثم يؤمن.
No.
يؤمن يقول آمين.
Then the imam says آمين.
ثم بعد هذا إن قرأ شيء من القرآن فلا بأس.
And then after this, if the imam or the person wants to recite something else from the Quran, there is no problem with this.
ثم يكبر التكبير الثاني ويصلي على النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام الصلاة الإبراهيمية.
Then the imam, he says الله أكبر, he makes the second takbira, and then he sends salutations upon the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم by saying الصلاة الإبراهيمية.
ثم يكبر التكبير الثالثة ويدعو للميت.
And then he performs or he says the third takbira, and then he supplicates for the deceased.
والأولى أن يدعو بما ورد عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And it is better for a person to supplicate for the deceased person with the supplications that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to use.
ثم يكبر التكبيرة الرابعة.
And then he says the fourth takbira.
ثم يسلم تسليمة واحدة أو تسليمتين.
And then he makes the تسليم. He says the salam either only once or twice.
ولو كبر خمس تكبيرات أو سبع تكبيرات يصح.
And if a person said five تكبيرات or six, it is okay.
سبعة.
Or seven.
ستة.
Five or seven.
نعم. طيب. بعد هذا نتكلم عما يكون من الآداب والأخلاق الإسلامية.
After this, we're going to talk about the manners, Islamic manners and the Islamic ethics and morals.
الأول إفشاء السلام.
Firstly, spreading the greeting of Islam.
عندما تدخل على أخيك أو عندما تنصرف تسلم.
So when you come to your Muslim brother or you are leaving the Muslims, you make salam. You give the greeting of salam.
نعم. وبهذا تحصل الألفة بين المسلمين.
And this is in order to bring about love and compassion between the Muslims.
ومن تمام السلام المصافحة باليدين.
And from the perfection of giving the greetings of salam is for a person to shake the hands.
ولا يمكن أن يصافح الرجل المرأة.
But it is not permitted for a man to shake the hands of a woman.
بل هو كبيرة من كبائر الذنوب.
Rather, this is from the major sins.
نعم. أيضا تشميت العاطس. إذا عطس الإنسان يقول الحمد لله.
Also from the Islamic manners and morals is that when a person sneezes, he says الحمد لله.
فتقول له يرحمك الله.
And the one who hears this says to him يرحمك الله.
ثم يجيب هو العاطس يقول يهديكم الله ويصلح بالكم.
And then the one who sneezed, he says يهديك الله ويصلح بالكم.
طيب. أيضا عندنا في الإسلام عيادة المريض, يعني نعود ونكرر على المريض الزيارة.
Also from the manners and the morals of a Muslim is visiting a person who is ill, meaning we repeat the visits to this person.
لكن الزيارة تكون في وقتها, في وقت الزيارة.
But the visiting has to be done in an appropriate time.
ولا تطيل البقاء عند المريض.
And you shouldn't stay too long with a person who is ill.
أو تأتي في أوقات يعني يحرج من الزيارة فيها, كأوقات مثلا زيارة الأهل أو أوقات تناول الدواء.
And neither should you visit the person who is ill in those times which are inappropriate or difficult for him. Like for example, if there's specific times or hours for family visits, then you don't visit in that time. Or if there's specific times in which he needs to take the medicine, you don't visit in that time.
ويقول له لا بأس طهور إن شاء الله.
And when you go to visit an ill person, you say لا بأس طهور إن شاء الله.
نعم, يعني تدعو له بما دعا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Meaning you supplicate for him with the supplications of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
يعني هذا المرض بإذن الله يكون لك به تطهير للذنوب ومحل الذنوب.
And the meaning of لا بأس طهور إن شاء الله is that this illness or this sickness which you are going through, this is going to be a form of expiation of your sins or purification, inshallah.
ولا تذكر عنده الموت.
And you don't mention death with him.
يعني ما تقنط من رحمة الله.
Meaning, don't make him lose hope in the mercy of Allah.
نعم. وكذلك لدينا زيارة للقبور.
Also, from the Islamic manners and morals is visiting the graveyards.
لدينا الزيارة للقبور يقسمها العلماء إلى ثلاثة أقسام.
So visiting the graveyards, the ulama have categorized it into three types.
زيارة شرعية.
There is an Islamic correct form of visiting the graveyards.
وزيارة بدعية.
And an innovated form of visiting the graveyards.
وزيارة شركية.
And then visiting the graveyards which entails shirk.
الزيارة الشرعية لابد لها من شروط.
So the correct Islamic legislated way of visiting the graveyards has to fulfill certain conditions.
لابد أن ينوي بهذه الزيارة تذكر الدار الآخرة.
Firstly, your intention for visiting the deceased or visiting the graveyard is that you want to be reminded of the hereafter.
نعم. وأنه سيرتحل من هذه الدنيا.
نعم. That a person remembers that he is also going to soon leave this dunya.
ولا يشد بزيارة القبور يعني لا أرحل يعني لا يسافر.
Now also, a person he doesn't undertake a journey in order to visit a grave.
ولا بد أن ينوي بهذه الزيارة الدعاء له وللأموات. دعاء الله سبحانه وتعالى له وللأموات.
And a person he intends when going to visit the graveyards that he is going to make dua to Allah, supplicate to Allah for the deceased and for himself.
نعم ولا يأتي بما يخالف الشرع في هذه الزيارة. ولا يأتي في هذه الزيارة بما يخالف الشرع.
And neither should a person say or do anything which goes against or opposes the Sharia.
فإن نوى بهذه الزيارة دعاء الأموات من دون الله فهي زيارة شركية.
So if a person intends by his visit to the graveyard that he's going to supplicate to the person in the grave, then this is the shirk which enters into when it comes to visiting graveyards.
وإن نوى دعاء الله عند القبور فهذه زيارة بدعية.
And if a person intends that he's going to go to the graveyard and he's going to supplicate to Allah, but he wants to make this supplication near that graveyard for whatever particular reason, then this is the innovated form of visiting.
أعطينا جواب. جواب. أي نعم. جزاك الله خير. هذا هم اللي أخبرني. نعم. ثم بعد هذا.
Then after this.
نذكر ما يتعلق بشيء من الآداب والأخلاق عند أهل الإسلام. نعم.
And then we're going to mention some other manners and morals that the people of Islam should have.
حسن الخلق.
First of all, general good character.
لابد أن تتأسى بالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان خلقه القرآن.
So we have to imitate the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had good manners, and his manners and his morals were the Quran.
السب والشتم هذا يقدر عليه كل أحد.
Insulting and swearing, anybody can do this. Everybody can insult and swear.
صحيح.
Correct.
نعم. لكن حسن الخلق هذا لا يقدر عليه إلا من وفق الله.
But as for good manners and lofty manners, then only the one who Allah has guided can do this.
وتدرك بحسن الخلق بالأدب وحسن الخلق درجة من يصوم الدهر ولا يفطر ويقوم الليل ولا ينام. بماذا؟ بحسن الخلق.
And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he mentioned that a person who assumes good manners and good morals and a good standard of character will achieve the reward of a person who fasts in the day without breaking his fast and he stands in the night in prayer.
نعم. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى وقل لعبادي يعني إن كنتم حقا عبادا لله ماذا يكون منا. نعم.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he said say to my worshippers, meaning if you truly want to be worshippers to Allah then how should you be.
يقول التي هي أحسن يعني لابد أن تخاطب غيرك بأحسن ما لديك.
Allah
يعني
said,
أحسن كلام تخاطب به غيرك. نعم.
Allah said say to my believing slaves or my worshipping slaves, that you should only say that which is good. Meaning, when you want to address another person or speak to another person, then only speak with him in the most best and beautiful of ways. So how do you love for people to speak to you and address you? So whatever you like other people to talk to you in that manner, then that's how you speak to other people. And if you do not do this, then you are committing one of the major sins.
لقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه فالذي لا يحب لأخيه مثل ما يحب لنفسه فهو مرتكب كبيرة من كبائر الذنوب.
Due to the saying of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, none of you truly believes until he loves for his brother that which he loves for himself. So whoever does not speak to his brother in the manner which he likes to be spoken to, then he is committing a major sin.
نعم تكون صادق في تصدق أولا مع الله ثم تصدق مع عباد الله.
And also from the manners or morals of a Muslim is to be truthful. And you have to be truthful with Allah first and then be truthful with the servants of Allah.
وتحرص أن لا تتكلم إلا بالصدق فالصدق من جاء.
And you should always be cautious that you only speak the truth and you do not speak anything which is not the truth, because only in truthfulness is there safety. And it is the way of entering into Jannah. And the opposite of speaking the truth, may Allah save us and give us pardon, is lying. And this takes a person to the fire.
الشرك بأنواع.
And also a person has to abandon all of the forms of shirk.
والكبائر والصغائر.
And the major sins and minor sins.
الغيبة والنميمة.
Backbiting and slandering.
فلا تتكلم في عرض أحد.
So do not speak in transgression of the honor of anybody.
وإن أردت أن تتكلم إما أن تتكلم بخير أو تصمت.
And if you want to speak, then either say something which is good or remain silent.
نعم. تحافظ على الصلوات المفروضة مع الجماعة الخمس.
Also from the etiquettes of a Muslim is that you try to persevere in the five daily prayers, praying with the congregation.
تحافظ على السنن الرواتب.
And also the Sunan al-Rawatib, the voluntary prayers which are highly recommended and attached to the five daily prayers, you also do them.
Raka'atayn qabl al-fajr.
And they are the two raka'at before fajr, the two units of prayer before fajr.
Wa raka'atayn qabl al-dhuhr, aw arba' raka'at qabl al-dhuhr.
And also two or four units of prayer before dhuhr.
وركعتين بعد المغرب وركعتين بعد العشاء.
And two units of prayer after Maghrib and two units of prayer after Isha.
تحافظ على الوتر.
And also that a Muslim is consistent upon praying the witr prayer.
وقت الوتر من بعد صلاة العشاء إلى أذان الفجر.
And the time for a person to pray the witr prayer is immediately after Isha prayer all the way to the Adhan of Fajr prayer.
وأقل الوتر ثلاث ركعات أقل الكمال هذا.
So
يعني قليل لكنه يعني أمر جميل. نعم.
So if a person wants to pray witr well, then the minimum amount he should pray is three.
لكن أقل القليل ركعة واحدة.
But if a person just wants to pray the absolute minimum amount, then one unit of prayer is enough as witr.
تقوم الليل تصلي لله سبحانه وتعالى.
Also from the manners and morals of a Muslim is standing at night and praying to Allah.
نعم تكثر من الصلاة في غير أوقات النهي.
And also that a person prays general voluntary prayers away from the prohibited times.
تحسن إلى المسلمين.
Also that you show goodness towards the Muslims.
تحسن حتى إلى الحيوانات.
In fact, even towards animals, we show them goodness.
نعم. بر الوالدين.
And obedience to parents.
وصلة الأرحام.
And keeping ties of kinship with family relatives.
وحسن الجوار.
And also living with your neighbors in a good manner.
حتى لو كان هذا الجار كافر.
Even if your neighbor is a non-Muslim.
على ما تقدم معنا من التعامل الوسط مع الكفار لا إفراط ولا تفريط.
Like we mentioned in the previous lessons, that a person when it comes to interacting with the non-Muslims is always in moderation, neither too extreme in either way.
تشكر النعم.
And also that a person, he thanks Allah and shows shukr or gratitude to Allah for the blessings.
بالقلب وباللسان وبالجوارح.
And this shukr, this gratitude is done in the heart, upon the tongue and with your actions.
وتصبر عند المصائب.
And also from the etiquettes of a Muslim is being patient when calamities and afflictions befall a person.
وتستغفر من الذنوب.
And that a person constantly seeks forgiveness for sins.
وتحذر. وتحذر من الشرك والبدع والمعاصي.
And that you should be careful and also warn other people from falling into shirk or sins.
تتشبه بالمسلمين لا بالكافرين.
قلت البدع كذا.
نعم.
And also innovations. Also that you should not resemble the non-Muslims, rather Muslims should be resembling each other.
تحرص على صيام الاثنين والخميس.
A person should try to always fast on Mondays and Thursdays.
وثلاث أيام من كل شهر.
And also 3 days in every month.
وبخاصة الثالث عشر والرابع عشر والخامس عشر من كل شهر هجري.
And especially the 13th, 14th and 15th of every Islamic month.
تحافظ على أذكار الصباح والمساء.
And also a Muslim is consistent upon the remembrances, the adhkar in the mornings and the evenings.
Adhkar adbar al-salawat al-mafroor.
And also the adhkar or the remembrances after the 5 daily prayers.
Al-adhkar عند النوم.
And also the remembrances before going to sleep.
Al-tasmiya عند al-akil aw al-shurb.
And that Muslims, we mention the name of Allah before eating and drinking.
وتحمد الله عند الفراغ.
And we praise Allah after finishing from eating and drinking.
تأشرب وتأكل بيمينك.
And that a Muslim eats and drinks with his right hand.
حتى الأخذ والإعطاء يكون باليمين لا بالشمال.
And even when it comes to giving something or taking something from somebody else, it's done with the right hand.
تأكل مما يليك.
And when you eat from the food which is closest to you.
نعم. وتأكل مما أباح الله سبحانه وتعالى ولا تأكل المحرمات ولا تشرب كذلك المسكرات.
And also that a Muslim only consumes that which Allah has permitted for him and doesn't use intoxicants and drugs and things like this.
ولا تجلس على مائدة فيها محرم من الطعام أو من الشراب كالخنزير أو الخمر.
And you as a Muslim should never sit on a table in which haram is being prepared or served, whether it is food like swine and pork or drinks like alcohol.
نعم. كذلك تصاحب الصالحين.
And also from the manners and morals of a Muslim is that he accompanies righteous people.
تحرص على أن تختم القرآن في أكثر ما يكون خلال شهر.
And that a person, a Muslim at the least, tries to complete a whole recitation of the Quran once every month.
وأقل مدة 3 أيام. يعني من 3 أيام إلى شهر.
And the minimum amount of days is 3 days, i.e. between 3 days and a whole month.
نعم. تجعل لك ورد من القرآن.
So you should have a daily portion of the Quran which you recite.
وهذا بإذن الله تعالى ييسر الله سبحانه وتعالى لك.
And this is something which Allah will make easy for you.
تبحث عن إنسان في المسجد تقرأ عليه القرآن وتصحح القراءة.
And try to find a person in the masjid to whom you can read the Quran and he can correct your recitation.
وتستمع.
And also you listen to the Quran.
إلى قراءة قارئ متقن.
You listen to the recitation of a qari who is good and proficient in his Quran.
ثم تنظر في تفسير هذه الآيات.
And also those ayat of the Quran which you are reading on a daily basis, you look at the books of tafsir or the books of explanation.
تجعل لسانك رطب بذكر الله، يعني دائما تذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى بالاستغفار، بالتهليل، بالتكبير، بالصلاة على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So your tongue should always be moist with the remembrance of Allah, always glorifying Allah, always praising Allah, sending salutations upon the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, constantly seeking forgiveness for your sins.
تأمر بالمعروف وتنهى عن المنكر.
And that from the manners or the etiquette of a Muslim is always enjoining the good and ordering the good, commanding the good and forbidding from evil.
لكن على ما توجب الشريعة يعني وسط لا إفراط ولا تفريط.
But this has to be done according to that which is legislated in the Sharia without going to any extreme.
الأمر الذي أنت لا تشك في 1% هذا تأمر به وإذا كان مأمور به وإذا كان محرم تنهى عنه.
So those things regarding which you have no doubt at all, this is a thing that either you should order people to do or forbid people from doing.
هل تشك في التوحيد؟
So for example, do you have any doubt regarding توحيد؟
وجوب الصلوات الخمس؟
Do you have any doubt regarding the obligation of the 5 daily prayers؟
وجوب الزكاة والصيام؟
And the obligation of الزكاة and fasting؟
فهذه لا تشك فيها 1%، إذا لابد أن تأمر بها.
So there isn't even a 1% doubt regarding this, and therefore you call and you invite the people to do this.
وتنهى عن الشرك لأنك لا تشك فيه أصلا.
And also because you have no doubt regarding shirk, you warn the people against a shirk.
والبدع والمعاصي.
And innovations and sinning.
لا تفتي لا في أي في لا تفتي في أي شيء حتى وإن كان شيء يسير.
However, you don't give a fatwa or you don't give rulings regarding anything.
وبخاصة في مسائل النكاح والطلاق.
And especially when it comes to issues relating to marriage and divorce.
غض البصر.
Also from the etiquettes of a Muslim is lowering the gaze when seeing the opposite gender.
نعم. كذلك البعد عن الأماكن التي فيها المعاصي والبدع والمنكرات.
And also a Muslim should remain distant from those places in which there is evil and innovations and sinning.
تدعو الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجنبك الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن.
And also from the etiquettes of a Muslim is always supplicating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He saves you from those afflictions which are either rampant or they are hidden.
تكثر من الطاعات.
And also that a Muslim should consistently try to always do good deeds, deeds of obedience to Allah.
وتجتنب المحرمات.
And a Muslim stays away and avoids the محرمات.
تقوى الله سبحانه وتعالى تجعل بينك وبين عذاب الله حاجز ووقاية.
And also from the etiquettes of a Muslim is التقوى, piety. And this means that you place between yourself and the punishment of Allah a barrier.
بفعل الأوامر واجتناب النواهي.
And this barrier is in you doing good deeds and staying away from evil deeds.
لكن على علم لا على جهل.
But this has to be based upon knowledge and not upon ignorance.
تصبر.
Also a Muslim should be patient.
تصبر أولا على التعلم أن تتعلم الشريعة.
A Muslim has to be patient upon seeking knowledge, learning Islamic knowledge.
ثم تصبر عن المحرمات.
And a person should be patient away from doing evil deeds.
ثم تصبر على ما قدر الله عليك من مرض أو فقر.
And also if Allah has decreed that some poverty hits you, some difficulty befalls you, some illness befalls you, you remain patient.
تجتنب السحر.
Also, you stay away from black magic or magic.
من اتيان السحرة.
Going to the magicians.
أو السماع لهم.
Or listening to the magicians.
أو الاتصال بهم.
Or contacting them.
أو الدخول على القنوات التلفزيونية.
Or even watching the television channels which contain this.
أو المواقع في المواقع الإلكترونية.
Or visiting websites regarding this.
أو إرسال رسائل لهم.
Or sending them text messages.
نعم. أيضا لا تتطير لا تتشام أبدا دائما تتفائل.
Also always be optimistic and never see bad omens or bad signs in anything.
تحسن الظن في الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And this is because a person should always have a good thought about Allah.
تتجنب السب والشتم واللعن.
And stay away from insulting and cursing others, reviling others.
تتجنب كل ما نهى عنه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
In fact, avoid everything which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم forbade you.
مثل سب الزمن, سب الدهر.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he forbade us from insulting the time.
سب الريح.
Insulting the weather, the wind, rain.
المؤمن لا يسب.
ولا يلعن. A believer does not insult. A believer does not curse. A believer does not revile.
نعم. أيضا لابد قال أن تعفو عمن ظلمك.
And also from the etiquettes of a Muslim is to pardon, forgive, and overlook those people who have oppressed you.
وتعطي من حرمك.
And the one who doesn't give to you, then you give to him.
وتصل من قطعك.
And the one who boycotts you, then you extend your hand to him.
يعني تعطي من أعطاك لا تعطي من لا يعطيك أصلا.
So giving to the person who gives to you, this is easy. But giving to the person who doesn't give to you.
وتعفو عمن عفى عنك لا عمن ظلمك.
And pardoning a person who is good to you is easy. But pardoning a person who is oppressing you and wronging you.
وتصل من وصلك لا تصل من قطعك.
And communicating with a person who communicates with you, this is easy. But communicating with a person who boycotts you and cuts off from you.
وبخاصة الأقارب.
And more so when they are your family relations.
نعم. تتعلم سيرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Also that you should learn and know about the seerah, the life of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ونعلم الأولاد.
And we teach our children the seerah.
نعم. وكذلك ننشرها بين الناس.
And also we should convey amongst the people the seerah of the Prophet. Teach the people the seerah of the Prophet.
تفتخر وتحمد الله سبحانه وتعالى أن جعلك من أتباع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And a person should feel proud and honored and also thank Allah that he has made him from the followers of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
لكن لا تقتر بنفسك.
But don't be deluded and deceived by yourself.
ولا تتكبر تترفع على الناس.
And don't be haughty and arrogant over the people.
تتواضع.
Rather be humble and modest.
تكون كما كان عليه السلف الصالح رضوان الله عليه.
So you should be how the righteous imams of the Salaf used to be.
تحرص ألا تعمل عمل ولا تقول قول ولا تعتقد شيء إلا وقد كان عليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. إلا وكن هذا كان عليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم والصحابة رضوان الله عليهم.
That any action that you do, any statement that you make, it should be that which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did and his companions.
تبتعد عن أن تكون من الفرق الضالة وتدعو الله سبحانه وتعالى.
Also, a person should not join with the deviated sects and groups, and you should ask Allah to save you from them.
التشبه بالمشركين.
And when it comes to resembling the non-Muslims or the people of shirk,
والتشبه بالنساء.
And imitating women,
والاختلاط,
and also the free mixing of the genders,
وكل ما يفتح عليك باب الفتنة.
In fact, anything which opens upon you an avenue of fitna.
يعني تغلق هذه الأبواب.
Meaning all of these doors and avenues should be closed.
لين الكلام مع النساء.
So, for example, speaking with women in a gentle manner.
نعم. وكذلك يعني الاختلاط.
And also mixing with the opposite gender.
فتغلق هذا الباب مع النساء.
So close this door straight away.
إلا عند الضرورة في شيء جعل الشارع لك فيه يعني حل.
Except in something or in a situation in which there is an absolute necessity or the Sharia has allowed you to do this.
الابتعاد عن سماع المحرمات.
Also, a person should distance himself, a Muslim should distance himself from listening to those things which are forbidden.
سماع الغناء.
Like listening to songs.
وكذلك هذه التي تسمى في هذه الأيام بالأناشيد.
And also listening to that which is called nowadays أناشيد.
تسمع القرآن.
Rather listen to the Quran.
والسنة.
And listen to the Sunnah.
والمنظومات العلمية.
And listen to Islamic poetry.
أما هذه التي يعني فيها شيء من الألحان وحتى الكلام الذي يكون فيها يعني ليس بكلام جيد أحيانا.
And as for listening to these songs or these anashid, then often it isn't something which is good.
تكثر من القراءة في القرآن.
Also from the etiquettes of a Muslim is reciting the Quran often.
وكتب الحديث.
And looking into the books of hadith.
وكتب السلف الصالح.
And reading the books of the great imams of the Salaf.
لا تقرأ أبدا قلنا لا في التوراة ولا في الإنجيل.
And that a Muslim doesn't read, doesn't look into the Torah or the Injil.
ولا في كتب علماء الكلام والمنطق والفلسفة.
And also that a person doesn't look into the books of philosophy and rhetoric.
قصص الغرام وما إلى ذلك.
Love stories like this.
وكتب المبتدعة.
And also that a person doesn't read the books of the innovators.
كتب المخالفين لأهل السنة والجماعة.
A person doesn't read the books of those people opposed to أهل السنة والجماعة.
تترضى عن الصحابة رضي الله عليهم.
From the etiquettes of a Muslim is always supplicating to Allah for the companions رضي الله عنهم.
ولا تذكرهم إلا بخير.
And that you should not speak about the companions except with goodness.
تحب كل واحد.
And that you as a Muslim, you have to love every person of Tawheed.
وبخاصة الأنبياء والرسل عليهم الصلاة والسلام.
And more specifically, the prophets and the messengers, may peace be upon them.
والملائكة.
And loving the angels.
والصحابة رضي الله عليهم.
Loving the companions, may Allah be pleased with them all.
والصالحين.
And loving the righteous people.
أئمة الإسلام.
Loving the Imams of Islam.
الأئمة الأربعة.
The four great Imams.
والعلماء.
And the ulama, the scholars,
وطلاب العلم,
and loving the students of knowledge,
وكذلك تحب كل ما جاءت به الشريعة من أحكام,
and you have to love every single ruling which the Sharia has legislated,
وكذلك الأمكنة التي يحبها الله سبحانه لابد من محبتها,
and you have to love those places which Allah loves.
المساجد.
Like the masajid.
مكة والمدينة.
Loving مكة and Medina.
وجبل أحد.
Loving Mount Uhud.
مثلا.
As an example.
وكذلك تحب الأزمنة التي يحبها الله سبحانه
وتعالى. Also you have to love those times, those days and weeks and months which Allah loves.
ثلث الليل الآخر.
For example, loving the last third of the night.
رمضان.
Loving Ramadan.
عشر من ذي الحجة مثلا.
Loving the first 10 days of the Hijjah.
ولابد أن تبغض كل كافر ومنافق.
And also you have to hate every كافر and every منافق.
لكن هذا البغض لا يؤدي إلى التعدي عليهم.
But this hatred of them doesn't mean that we have to transgress against them.
تدعوه إلى الإسلام.
Rather we call them to Islam.
تتعامل معه في البيع والشراء.
We buy and sell with them.
لا تتعدى عليه بالقتل ولا بالسب ولا بالشتم.
We don't use violence against them. We don't insult them. We don't revile them.
أو السرقة.
Or steal from them.
لا تشاركوا في أعياده ولا في احتفالاته.
But at the same time, we don't partake in their festivals and celebrations.
تسعى لأن تكون عبد تطيع الله سبحانه وتعالى وتعلم أنك وجدت في هذه الدنيا لعبادة الله.
You should strive and work hard to be a person who is always obedient to Allah. And you know that the reason behind your existence is the worship of Allah.
تنام على ما ورد عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في نومه عليه الصلاة والسلام.
So when, for example, you sleep, then you sleep according to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
تذكر الأذكار قبل النوم.
You say the remembrances and the أذكار before going to sleep.
تتجنب النوم على البطن.
And then you don't sleep upon your stomach.
نعم. وكذلك لا تكون وحدك منعزل.
And also don't be isolated from the rest of the Muslims.
تخالط الناس لكن بقدر الحاجة.
Rather, you should mix in and socialize with the people according to the level of necessity.
يعني لا تنعزل عنهم بالكلية ولا تخالطهم بالكلية. تكون وسط.
Meaning, a person doesn't totally isolate himself from the rest of the Muslims, and neither does he always and totally mix in with them.
لابد أن نجتمع على ما اجتمع عليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم والصحابة رضي الله عليهم.
Rather, we have to unite and congregate upon everything which the Prophet and the companions united upon.
لابد من الاجتماع على ما اجتمع عليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم والصحابة رضي الله عليهم لا الفرقة.
So we have to be united upon that which the Prophet was united upon and not be disunited or in discord.
نجتمع على العبادات على الصلاة.
So we unite and congregate in the worship of Allah in the prayer.
حتى على الطعام نجتمع حتى يبارك الله سبحانه وتعالى لنا فيه.
Even when it comes to eating, we congregate and we eat together, so Allah places blessings in that food.
تتجنب الألبسة المحرمة.
And also that a Muslim should avoid wearing those clothing or those garments which are haram.
لبس الحرير والذهب على الرجال.
Men wearing gold and silk.
الإسبال في الإزار ما أسفل الكعبين ففي النار.
And dragging our garments below our ankles, because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whatever is below the ankles is in the fire.
أو الألبسة التي فيها تشبه بالمشركين.
Or those types of clothing or garments which are specific to the non-Muslims.
أو فيها كشف للعورة.
Or any clothing which uncovers our private parts.
نعم. أو التي تكون شعار للكفار.
And any type.
يعني عرفوا بهذه الألبسة أنها لهم ليست للمسلمين.
Any type of clothing or garment which is like a symbol for the non-Muslims or something which they are known by and the Muslims don't wear.
لا تتكلم في السياسة إطلاقا.
And that a person doesn't speak about politics.
لأن من السياسة ترك السياسة.
Because from politics is a person leaving it.
فالسياسي المحنك العاقل هو الذي لا يتكلم في السياسة.
Or from diplomacy is a person leaving speaking about politics. So the intelligent person is a person who avoids speaking about politics.
تدعو الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يغنيك عن الحكام عن غير الحكام.
So if you keep supplicating to Allah, then Allah will free you from the rulers and other than the rulers.
ولكن أن تطلب من المخلوق شيء أطلب من الخالق سبحانه وتعالى.
So why request and seek things from the creation? Why don't you seek from the creation?
لا تتكلم فيما لا يعنيك.
Do not speak about those things which do not concern you.
من الكلام في السياسة.
So speaking about politics.
وغلاء الأسعار.
And how prices have become very expensive.
وأشياء يعني ليس لك فيها دخل.
And anything that you have no involvement with.
فماذا يعنيك؟
So what does it matter to you?
أن توحد الله سبحانه وتعالى.
You remain upon توحيد. You worship Allah upon توحيد.
وأن تعبد الله.
You worship Allah.
لا تجمع بين المعصية والمجاهرة بها.
And never combine between doing a sin and then showing other people that you're doing this sin.
إذا وقعت في معصية وكل بني آدم خطأ فماذا تصنع؟
If you fall into a sin and every human being falls into sins, then what should you do?
تستغفر وتتوب.
Seek forgiveness from Allah. Repent to Allah.
وتعزم أن لا تعود.
And have a strong determination that you're never going to go back to that sin.
وتكون صادقا في هذا.
And you have to be truthful in this.
وتؤدي الحقوق إلى أهله إذا كان هناك حق.
And you fulfill and repay the rights if you have taken the right from a person.
تحترم الكبير.
That you have to respect and honor the elderly.
وكذلك الصغير.
And also the young person.
وتتعامل مع الكفار كما تعامل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And that you deal or interact with the non-Muslims like the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to do so.
نعم. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى لي ولكم التوفيق والسداد والله أعلم وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم.